she remain.
Got it, Edie.
Wait, since when does a virtual intelligence make requests?
Edie's an AI. Fully self-aware.
Oh, I knew it. I knew Joker was lying.
Jeff requested that I pretend to be a simple VI to protect myself. I apologize for the deception.
Thanks, Edie, and I apologize for all those times I talked about how attractive your voice was. Anyway, shall I give you a tour? I think you'll be impressed by the new upgrades. In the CIC, you'll find the galaxy map where you can set the Normandy's destination. You can also check your messages at your private terminal. The War Room houses a strategic command center for mission-specific intel and war analysis. The shuttle bay contains an armory where you can modify your equipment between missions. Finally, Liara has set up a lot of hardware down in the old XO office on Deck 3. I think she's claimed that room. And there you are. Still the same ship as before, it just flies Alliance colors now. Speaking of which, I believe Admiral Hackett would like to speak to you at the VidCom.
Commander, Udina updated me on your meeting with the Council. Sounds like they're running scared.
We did present them with a lot of unknowns. They're feeling threatened and want immediate solutions, not theories.
Theories are all we've got right now. What's your plan?
I'm trying to get the Turian Primarch for a summit meeting with the Asari and Salarians. I'll bypass the Council and appeal directly to their leadership.
That's good, I like it. This is where we start laying the groundwork for our counterattack.
Unfortunately, we don't have a whole lot to back it up right now.
Then build alliances. Gather everything and everybody you can for the cause.
What about the Prothean device?
Find me people who can help build it, and if you can't, I'll take ships, soldiers, supplies, whatever you can get. We need to keep hitting the Reapers across every theater of war they open. Buy us time to figure out the device.
And when it's finished?
Assuming it ever is, we pool all our resources. Think of it as a giant armada for delivering the device when the Reapers are most vulnerable. The stronger you can make that armada, the better the chances of punching through.
You can count on it, sir.
It's not just me, it's everyone back on Earth. Anderson and what's left of the Alliance forces have to hold out until we deal with the enemy.
I understand, Admiral.
Good. Then make it happen, Commander. I'll be expecting regular updates on your progress. Hack it out.
Commander, the Alliance has found a new Cerberus lab on Sanctum. Admiral Hackett would like you to investigate. Commander, come to check on your new recruit.
Just wanted to see how you were doing.
Still trying to get my bearings. When I was working on the Normandy's upgrades, I left at the end of the day. I didn't even have a toothbrush or a change of clothing until I made some emergency purchases on the Citadel.
Next time you need something, just ask. You're not alone here.
Oh, it's no trouble, Commander. I'm sure you have larger concerns.
We can put in a requisition order.
My toothbrush is a Scission Promark 4. It uses tiny mass effect fields to break up plaque and massage the gums. It costs 6,000 credits.
Okay, yeah. You're on your own with that.
In any event, I appreciate you giving me the chance to stay. Was there anything else?
How'd you end up in the military anyway?
My family didn't have money for university. When the Alliance saw my aptitude scores, they offered me a full scholarship. I served my required years after graduation and decided to stay. I really like the challenges of the lab. Although, I'm sure I'll grow to love frontline service as well.
I'm surprised you're worrying about a toothbrush. We got bigger problems right now.
Oh, believe me. Seeing the Reapers on Earth was terrifying. But I won't help anybody by bursting into tears here in the CIC, will I? Being here on the Normandy helps. If anyone in the galaxy can stop the Reapers, it's you. And if flagging your messages and managing strategic intel helps you in any way, then it's worth it.
You worked in Alliance R&D?
Yes. You'd think quantum entanglement would make communication easy, but imagine incorporating multiple incoming sources and then networking them with extrapolations of time-lag data to construct a coherent situation GUI. It's an exciting challenge. For me, anyway.
Where are you from originally?
A colony in the Terminus systems, actually. Though I studied on Earth, at Oxford. My parents were from London. They loved Earth, but they wanted the freedom a colony life could offer. If they stayed in London, I imagine they'd be dead right now.
A lot of people back on Earth are still alive, and counting on us.
Quite true, Commander.
Carry on, Specialist.
Hey, Commander. You know, I had my doubts about the Council. But after years of ignoring your warnings, they're finally willing to step up and tell you they just can't help.
They're doing everything they can.
Did they at least validate our parking? Well, let me know if you want me to get them on the channel and then hang up on them. You know, for old time's sake. Commander? Commander?
Commander Shepard, it's a pleasure to see you again.
You're the drone from the Shadowbroker ship.
Dr. Tassoni now refers to me as Glyph, instead of Info Drone, 95% of the time. If you have a moment, I'd like to draw your attention to a terminal in her office. It analyzes information packages. If you find any useful data, I can research upgrades for you.
And what should I be looking for?
I'll inform you if you found relevant data. When you do, return to this terminal for your choices. In the meantime, Dr. Tassoni would like to speak with you. Have a pleasant day.
Meeting with the Council didn't go too well, huh?
It was less than ideal.
Yeah, I'm shocked.
At least the Council can't deny the Reapers exist. But I'm not sure how much comfort that is while they bicker over which portion of the galaxy to save.
Wow. Becoming the big info broker's turned you into a real cynic, Liara. I like it.
I'm flattered. I think.
Looks like you brought more than just that drone from your ship.
A few things were necessary. I'd be a very silent shadow broker without data feeds.
So you have access to your resources?
What I can get. We'll need it to research this Prothean device. Until we understand precisely what it does, it's far too dangerous to use.
Do the Protheans actually complete this weapon?
You mean, will it work? They wouldn't have poured their last resources into this device if they thought otherwise. But we really need to find out just what kind of weapon they left us.
It'd be nice to know we're not kids playing around with a loaded gun.
Absolutely. The damage it could cause if it backfired is unthinkable. This will be difficult even for us. If something happens on a mission, if either one of us are hurt. Shepard, there's something I need to ask before we go any further. I know you and Garrus grew close. Is that in the past? Should I forget there was anything between us?
A lot has happened since then, Liara. I don't think we'd work anymore.
Really? I thank you for letting me know.
I think it's best for both of us.
Of course. Well, anyway, I should get down to business. There's a lot to do if we're to discover exactly what the Protheans left us.
This terminal contains non-essential correspondence from your allied forces. Dr. Tassoni has granted you access.
Hello again, Shepard.
How much do you know about this Prothean artifact?
Very little. We're fortunate enough data survived to piece together the blueprints. Decoding them will require as many specialists as we can find.
It's that high tech?
I'd have killed for a glimpse of it during graduate school.
You brought your little helper with you?
Its name is Glyph. It helps sort through all the data that led me to the archive on Mars.
It was a pleasure to be of assistance, Doctor.
Glyph's interfaced with the data feeds. Its analytical software should come in handy.
What's been happening with you as the broker, Liara?
It's been exciting. The old broker's ship, impressive, but it was never meant to be space-worthy. Which meant the elusive man eventually tracked me down on Hagalaz.
What happened?
I knew he was coming. Ferran and I loaded as much of the ship's specialized hardware onto a shuttle as we could. We got away from Cerberus's ships after arranging an appropriate distraction.
What kind of distraction?
Sending the broker's ship exploding into a Cerberus cruiser. I don't think the elusive man expected me to give up my resources in such a spectacular fashion.
Can you still operate as the broker without the ship?
Well, I couldn't let the elusive man have it. I saved what was crucial. My network of agents is intact, although the Reapers have taken a toll on their numbers. It's taking a while to re-establish contact.
So where is Ferran if you two escaped?
He convinced me he was recovered enough to work, and I do need more agents.
Agent Ferran didn't report any injuries during his last call to you, Doctor.
True. Given what he survived, I should probably worry less.
What have you been up to since we last saw each other?
Since you helped me defeat the Shadow Broker, I started looking for defenses against the Reapers. The Protheans were the only ones with substantial information on them. The older civilizations barely had records. I knew the elusive man was hunting for the same thing when our agents began crossing paths.
Like on Mars.
I thought I'd covered my tracks, but he had surveillance there all along.
We'll talk later, Liara.
Of course.
Enjoy your day.
Commander?
Everything okay down here, Doctor?
The Alliance team cleaned up and restocked, but it's still my old med bay. Feels like home.
Welcome back.
Thank you. Let's waste no time, if I may. I'd like to examine you.
Nothing wrong with me, is there?
No, but we should keep an eye on all those cybernetic implants Cerberus grafted into you.
Expensive stuff bringing me back.
And worth every penny. Let's just make sure everything is okay.
I guess a checkup never hurts. Just no scalpel this time, Doc.
Alas, to my great disappointment, it is nothing invasive. I'm just going to run some diagnostics on your implants, and it'll take a few readings. The procedure we did for your scarring has produced a lovely synthetic protein overlay. And your body has accepted the implants quite nicely.
It did better. Sure didn't come cheap.
That's it. You're the picture of health.
How's our inventory of meds?
The med bay was fully stocked before you left Earth. We should be good for a long time, even given the amount of fire you take each day.
Do you ever regret working for Cerberus?
We didn't work for them. We used them. If I were to feel anything, it would be guilt. We took their money, took their best people, took their best ship. We used them to defeat the Collectors, and now we are using their resources against them. So no, I don't regret it one bit.
You never mentioned any of your family.
None to speak of, really. I'm the last of a prestigious line of medical professionals. The Alliance is my spouse, and you're all my children. I'm blessed with many close friends. But with each Alliance vessel taken, I lose one or two. We need to end this war.
See you around, Doctor.
Take care, Shepard.
Commander, welcome back to the Normandy. Or maybe you should be saying that to me.
Engineer Adams, what are you doing here?
I was put in charge of the drive core retrofits. My experience on the Normandy SR-1 made me an obvious choice.
So, what do you think of our SR-2?
She's incredible. If there's one nice thing I can say about Cerberus, it's that they know how to build a ship. And about that, Cerberus, I mean, I owe you an apology.
How so?
Back when you got this ship, Dr. Chakwas contacted me, asking me to help with your mission against the Collectors. I refused. I didn't have your back, and I'm sorry for that.
Why didn't you join us?
I saw what happened to you when the Normandy went down. I didn't trust that it was really you, and I certainly didn't trust Cerberus. Also, as an officer of the Alliance, I don't just leave my post, you know?
Your Alliance first. That's the way it should be.
Thank you, Commander. Glad to be aboard.
Is your family okay?
My parents are serving on Viridian Zenith, an Alliance agricultural vessel. My sister is a navigator on the SSV Benjamin Davis. Happy to report that both vessels are safely under Hackett's command.
Does the new Normandy stack up to the old SR-1?
Stack up? It blows the old ship away. The Tantalus drive core has been completely overhauled. The SR-2 might be nearly twice the size, but the new drive core is 3 times bigger. This ship can fly. That said, Cerberus isn't too high on safety. If pushed past her limits, this core would vent into engineering. Guess it gives my team incentive to keep her well-balanced during a firefight.
Do your job or get vaporized.
Pretty much. I noticed you upgraded the kinetic barriers with cyclonic technology. Should help reduce the draw when under missile fire.
Hopefully that means fewer vaporized engineers.
The IES stealth system is significantly improved. It can handle a higher blue shift of our emissions.
And that means?
We should be able to drop out of FTL without triggering every sensor in range. Very handy for stealth reconnaissance. All in all, the Normandy is a marvel of engineering.
What do you think of Edie?
We had a good talk during the retrofit. A little strange at first, talking shop with an AI.
AI? I thought Edie posed as a VI to keep the likes of you from unplugging her.
Yeah, but I saw through her. Have you seen her hardware? Processing power is off the charts. And then there were the problems that kept fixing themselves. If I hadn't had her pegged, I would have sworn I was losing it.
You never expressed any skepticism, Lieutenant Adams.
I figured I'd better play it safe with the Cerberus AI, Edie. No offense.
None taken. As long as you keep your fingers out of my cognizance processors.
In the beginning, I tried disconnecting her from key processes without giving myself away. Easier said than done. But Joker seemed to trust her, and in time I saw her advantages. Even grew to like her.
Carry on, Adams.
Aye, aye, ma'am.
How's your new assignment working out, Allers?
Fairly normal, except for the unshackled AI, Matriarch Benezia's daughter, and the communicator that can reach Earth. The first two, I can deal with. That last one gets my attention.
So what are you asking for, exactly?
Anything from Earth is the lead story right now. That's not opinion, it's fact.
Maybe I can pass on a few non-classified progress updates.
Seriously? You just doubled my ratings. I don't need FaceTime, just a data upload.
Tell people what's really happening on Earth. We need long recruiting lines on every planet after you air a story.
I can do this, Commander. Remind me to tell you about the time I made an Elcor cry. Commander?
Bad dog.
Lieutenant Steve Cortez, shuttle pilot. Got news about our supply chains, Commander.
Nice to meet you, Lieutenant. What's going on?
Sorry to just jump in, Commander. There's so much to be done, I get caught up in the tasks at hand.
He's always like that. You need to chill out, Esteban.
So you do care, Mr. Vega? Or is that the Cerveza talking again?
So what's happening with our supply chains, Lieutenant?
Alliance procurement chains are in chaos, but the Citadel's economy is still running. I can network to Citadel retailers. You can view inventory and make purchases right from this console.
When I network to a new store, I'll let you know.
It does cost more to coordinate delivery to the Normandy, so it's cheaper to buy supplies when you're there.
So, you're my shuttle pilot, but you're setting up procurement chains?
I wasn't assigned as Normandy's pilot. Not much need for one on a dry dock ship. I was overseeing the retrofit of the cargo hold. I'm quite familiar with the operation and maintenance of the UT-47 Kodiak and the M-44 Hammerhead. In my experience, it made sense for me to take over as shuttle pilot when we left Earth. Especially given Mr. Vega's love of mid-air collisions.
To save the day, pendejo!
I'm also responsible for logistics, making sure the armory and shuttle are properly stocked and maintained.
Do you maintain this armory?
I share that duty with our illustrious Mr. Vega. Though I believe the only weapon he really cares to maintain is himself.
You know you love the show, Esteban.
The first retrofit we did was to move the armory down from Deck 2. I'm not sure what Cerberus engineers were thinking. Now you get off the elevator, pick your gear, and head right into the shuttle.
Just like the original Normandy.
Welcome back to the Alliance, Commander.
How long have you been with the Alliance?
About 10 years. I enlisted in First Fleet serving on the SSV Hawking, flying F-61 Tridents mostly. I love the Trident. It practically dances in low atmo. I spent as much time tinkering on my bird as flying her. Got a bit of a reputation.
So you can fly fighters and fix them?
Yeah. And I got a knack for procurement, too. They were grooming me for CAG, but my skill set made me more valuable commanding a flight deck. They assigned me to the Normandy retrofit team about 5 months ago to oversee all cargo bay modifications.
What happened to the M-44 Hammerhead?
It was sent to the tech labs for a retrofit. To afford mobility with such a small ESO core, its design sacrificed armor plating. The lab engineers are trying to improve that. After the Reaper invasion, those labs are probably just a pile of rubble.
The Kodiak seems a bit different.
Good eyes, Commander. This is the UT-47A Kodiak. It's got an upgraded ESO core and prototype stealth technology based on the Normandy design. For quick drops, I can get you in and out virtually undetected. She flies like a brick, so that's why you need a good pilot.
You were stationed on Earth. Do you have family there?
I'm an only child. Lost my parents years ago. I had a husband back when I was stationed at Ferris Fields. The collectors took out the whole colony. I'd rather not talk about it.
Keep up the hard work, but don't kill yourself.
Yes, Commander.
Hey, Shepard. How'd it go with the council?
Same as usual. Non-committal. Unhelpful.
Bet they still wanted you to help them out, no?
Yep. We're going to rescue a Turian Primarch from Palavin.
Sounds like fun. Never been to the Turian homeworld. You come down here for something? Or are you just looking?
I did just come to chat, but I might stay for the show.
Have to work harder than that if you want me to blush. Not sure what there is to talk about. You already know my service record.
I don't, actually. I didn't have access to personnel records when we met.
Right. Forgot about that. Well... Think you can dance and talk at the same time?
Oh, I can dance.
Okay, Lola. Let's do this.
Don't let my good looks fool you, Vega. I got my share of scars.
You remind me of my old CO.
Oh, yeah? And who was that?
Captain Tony. He was a hard-ass son of a bitch, but a good leader.
Was?
Died. With most of my squad. Protecting a civilian colony from a collector attack.
And the colony?
It was either them, or the intel we had on the collectors. Intel we could have used to destroy him. I chose the intel.
Sorry. That's a tough call.
The best part was, we didn't really need the intel in the end. Because you were out saving the galaxy by taking down the entire Collector homeworld.
You didn't know? You can't blame yourself, Vega.
Who says I'm blaming myself?
I do.
You a shrink too?
No, but that stunt back on Mars was reckless. You're lucky to be alive.
So?
So, maybe you don't care if you live or die.
Or maybe. I'm just willing to do whatever the fuck it takes to end this goddamn war.
Maybe you are. But if you're half as good as I think you are, we need you alive.
Thanks for the pep talk.
Anytime.
Hey. Thanks for the dance, Lola.
Lola, huh?
You kind of look like a Lola.
You're cute. So I'll let you get away with it. For now.
That's it. Now you made me blush. Hey again. What's up?
What's with you and the nicknames?
It's just my way of remembering people. Some people just don't match their names, you know? So, I just give them a new one.
So I'm a Lola, huh?
Yeah, my best friend's sister growing up was Lola. Older sister. Hot. Tough.
Right. You mentioned a mission you had against the Collectors. What happened?
Pretty much what I said. Things went foobar, and I was one of the few to make it out. If you want the rest of the story, you're gonna have to get me really drunk, or...
Or what?
That's about it. Sorry, Commander. Just not interested in talking about that. Next topic?
You had a hard time leaving Earth. You still want to head back?
Hell yeah. But I get it now. It's not where I'd be most useful.
Not yet, anyway.
We'll get back there.
I know. And I'll do whatever it takes to get us there, Commander.
Maybe no more shuttle crashes.
No promises now that I've gotten the taste for it. Besides, I like to keep Esteban on his toes.
You got family back on Earth?
Yeah, an uncle. Retired military. Got a few cousins I haven't heard from in a while.
You and your uncle close?
Yeah. He was the reason I joined the Marines and was about the only good thing in my life after my mom died.
No dad?
He's there. Somewhere. But I'm not sure I'd call him family. Not anymore. I would like to find out how my uncle's doing, though.
I take it you and Lieutenant Cortez know each other?
Yeah, Esteban did a stint on Fel Prime where me and my squad were stationed. I caught up with him on Earth a few months back. He's a good guy. Just don't tell him I said so. It'd go to his head.
I'll talk to you later.
You bet.